FOMO, fear of missing out. Hello guys, I'm Nona Prince and today we're talking about the Indian film A Death in the Ganj, written and directed by Kongana Sen Sharma, with an ensemble cast of Vikrant Masse, Kalki Kekla, Ranveer Shore, Gulshan Devaiya, Tilotama Shome, Jim Sarb, Om Puri and Tanuja. First of all, just a brilliant film. If you haven't seen it, watch it on Amazon Prime. Now technically in all aspects it's really really good. The film transports you to this era of 1978 in a small place in Bihar. The performances were just amazing. What do you expect from this brilliant cast? They're not be that famous, but they are the best actors today working in the indie space. Now the film is in English. There are some dialogues in Hindi, Bengali, but man, Indians talking in English on screen, I don't think, why doesn't it work? I don't understand. In the beginning, it feels off, but by the end, you don't even realize they're speaking in English. Now guys, if you haven't seen it, there'll be spoilers ahead, so stop right here, go watch it and come back. This film is full of visual storytellings, metaphors, analogies. There's so much going on in a scene. There's so much subtext. There's things between the lines. And you have to be attentive to catch all of it. I did catch a lot of things, but I think I have to give it a second viewing. Now, according to me, the major theme of the film is FOMO, as I talked before, fear of missing out. You know, the feeling of being left out, your existence doesn't matter, that you don't belong here. And that's what Vikrant Masse's character Shoot 2 is going through. He's just used for work, made fun of, he's the weakling. Nobody really cares about him. No one even realizes if he's around or not, as if he's a ghost. Later in the film, we see the target boat, which was kept in the storage, full of dust, and it's brought back because it has to be used again. It's remembered only when it's needed, just like Shoot 2. And at the end of the film, he stands exactly where the target boat had to be kept. Remember in the beginning of the film, we see that his name is not there on the family tree. But by the end of the film, his blood is. And at the end of the film, he finally becomes the ghost which he always was. The irony is, now no one will ever forget about him. But he is no more. The film also talks about the image of man. He has to be bold. He cannot get scared. He has to be tough, be macho, be strong. That's what society expects man to be. And he has to take up responsibility. And that's also a theme on the film. Shoot 2 doesn't take responsibility. He failed in the exams. He's out of the hostel. He's not going to his mother. He wants to run away from all of this. You know, Tilotma's character Bonnie, she's not responsible either. Even about her own daughter. There's a scene in the film where you get to know that Bonnie had a lot of pets, but some died, some got lost. And that shows how careless she was. And even Tanya, her daughter, even she doesn't know where her puppy is. She's not taking care of it. Again, the puppy represents you too. They'll use you until they need you and then you are on your own. When everyone is searching for Tanya and Bonnie is at home, her father is drunk and he says, "Don't worry, forget it, Hathiram is gone. Someone would have eaten it." And Hathiram is a turtle we got to know about before, who just left and never returned. Now this scene is treated as if he's just drunk and saying anything, but there's a meaning behind it, that she has treated her own daughter like the pet Hathiram. Now Bonnie blames Shoot 2 for everything, whereas her husband Nandu blames her for everything. And because he's a man, it's not his responsibility to take care of his daughter. Ranveer Shaw's character Vikramjeet is running away from his marriage. No one wants to owe up to their responsibility. Guys, if you're finding value in the video, do hit the like button, because when you do that, YouTube promotes this video more people can watch it. Also, consider subscribing and hit the bell icon to get notification whenever a new video drops. We also see a lot of talk about death and a lot of visuals that represent death. Shoot 2 lost his father. We also visit a cremation ground. And remember that scene where they're calling the ghost and the ghost tells Shoot 2 will be the first to die? That was a clear foreshadowing. He was the first one to die. And in that ghost calling scene, they're calling for evil spirits and good spirits. But honestly, the living human is more evil than the ghost. There's also a layer of class difference. We see how privileged these people are. And there are small interactions here and there in the film where talk about it's so cold, people waking up late, it's too cold to take a bath. But that doesn't apply to the workers and the house help. They are not working on time. It's a big issue. We have to complain. The whole story is knitted so finely, so perfectly. How all these elements are stitched together so precisely, and it becomes a wonderful film. See, this is a very rare film, because the issues it is tackling are everywhere. Some movies are just talking about that issue particularly. But this film takes a narrative which has all these elements, which is set in this real world, telling a story of this family and what happened. And through that, we are exposed to so many things happening around us, which we don't even see with the open eyes. See, there's no one character at fault. There's no one villain, not at all. All are villains, or neither of them are. That's the real life. Only if people were compassionate enough, if they had empathy for others, maybe the Shoot 2s of the world would be alive today. So guys, that was the video. If you enjoyed it, the thumbs up button, share this video, let me know in the comments your thoughts. If you haven't subscribed yet, check out the videos. If you like them too, look at subscribing, and I'll see you next time.